Alright guys, this is going to be a really short video. First of all, I'm having a bad bout of flu and sore throat. Secondly and mainly, except for T-Rex and the abelisaurids, including my favorite dinosaur Carnotaurus, I'm really least interested in theropods. Thirdly and specifically, I know even less about the ornithomimosaurs. But this one is such a cool looking model, I had to get it. Caudipteryx means tail feather, from the Latin cauda meaning tail, and the Greek pteryx meaning feather. Exquisite specimens have been found, including feather imprints. The bauplan is remarkably bird-like, with long legs and a short, boxy skull. I don't know how to measure this exactly, since much will depend on posture, but I'll give you the height of 13.5 centimeters and 5.3 inches, and the horizontal length of 11.5 centimeters or 4.5 inches. The intended scale is 1 to 6, so I'll just put him here next to Barney Ross. Salone is 1.77 meters or 5 foot 8 inches. And you can judge for yourself if this is right. The model is 70 grams or 0.15 pounds or 2.5 ounces. His name Junlang means handsome and cheerful, and he looks it. The model stands independently, and because he's so light, you might actually not have to use the stand, but with a caveat. Now in mine, I don't know if it's intentional, there's a slight lean, and depending on surface, he doesn't stand at all. Now here's the head of Caudipteryx. I really like the fade of blue into the front of the skull. And the eyes are nicely painted, with a carefully positioned eyeball, surrounded by a fade of orange. You can already see the beginnings of that feathery integument. From the top, the colours blend really nicely together. Now here's that very nice detail all around. Going down the pectoral area now. Then down the back. You'll see a rather coarse looking downy texture here. You'll also notice that even though this appears black at first, it's got so much infusion of blue, it's really a blue-black. And under my rather bright lighting, I think you can appreciate that more easily. Into the wings. You see the nice texture of the coverts. Then these pernicious feathers. And the banded colours are really nicely chosen, though I think a little stark at times. You guys can speak more intelligently about feathers than me, so that's all I'll say. Now these wings run off the second finger, and I like how the first two digits protrude out. Really can't wait to see how PNSO would do a Maniraptoran. Here are the medial sides. Down the legs. With those scutes. And on the lateral side, you see that while it's the same blue-black, on the medial side, it's almost a dark red-brown. So there's a difference in colour. Very nice detail. The form of the bird-like foot is really well expressed here. With those soft tissue pads on the underneath. This really looks like bird feet I've seen. Now we get to the tail, with the same color and pattern theme in the wing feathers. In a banded pattern that's been suggested by possible preserved melanosomes. Though again, I feel a little bit more subtlety in the transitions would have been really nice. You see the twin fan form in the tail here. Just a nice figure overall, and one that's gotten me interested to learn more about the group. Alright, comparisons. Unfortunately, I've next to nothing to show you, just two. In terms of downy animals, here's the really cool PNSO Dinochirus. The PNSO Therizinosaurus. Really nice taking down some of these oldies and admiring them up close again. We'll finish off with the Wilson T-Rex. And the Cameron. So that's it. It's a nice little figure, and significant because first, it's moving into larger scale territory, which means that PNSO can now run riot with the dromaeosaurids, the smaller primitive ankylosaurs, and even prehistoric amphibians. And secondly, we've now seen a real infusion of variety in the 2025 lineup so far. I hope this means more group sprees will not be the pattern this year. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you in the next video.